This tutorial shows the calculation of the effect size following significant post-hoc tests after a one-way ANOVA in R. It is common practice to calculate the effect size D after observing differences in pairwise t-tests. First, we need the R statics package, which by now, when you followed the series, will be already active. I'll start with the data frame and add the pipe operator. The next line is the Cohen's underscore D function that has the dependent variable followed by tilde, the small wave symbol, and the group variable. The effect size can be found in the column F size. Please note that effect sizes will always be reported as positive values. The negative sign is caused by the order of the groups. Finally, you have to classify the magnitude of the effects for which you consider the p-value being small enough. I already mentioned that dichotomizing the decision against the null hypothesis by strictly looking at the p-value should be avoided. The magnitudes provided here are from Cohen 92, a power primer, page 157. If the effect size exceeds 0.2, it is a small effect, if it exceeds 0.5, it is a medium effect, and if it exceeds 0.8, it can be classified as a large effect, as is the case in my example. However, please check if similar studies in your research field exist and compare your effect size with the given ones. If no comparable study exists, use the common thresholds within your research field. If those are also non-existent, you can do what I did, you can refer to Cohen 92, a power primer. When you're done, you have to write up the results. The video that appears now will show you how.